Hello, my name is Rory Cranston, and I'm a market development manager for Bayer Crop Science. Today, we're here on this recorded webinar to talk a little bit about one of our new products and new innovations that's going to be available for the 2024 season, Varro FX, our new cross-spectrum spring and winter wheat herbicide. Me and some of my colleagues, Amanda Federchuk and Samantha Clemis, are going to be going through some of the attributes of this product here today. So in this webinar, what you can expect is to understand and learn about what is Varro FX. What are some of the technical attributes that it brings to us? What is the new innovation that comes around with it? You'll also see some of the results that have been a product of a recent market development studies and our in-field applications. We'll also be looking at past just that efficacy crop safety, but how this new solution, this new formulation brings about ease of use, ease of application. We'll then all tie it up of some of the definite benefits and stagings of this product. Now, I would like to hand it over to my colleague, Amanda Federchuk, to speak about what is Varro FX, some of the technical attributes, as well as some of the results we have seen.
Hi, everyone. My name is Amanda Federchuk, and I'm the market development representative out of Northwest Saskatchewan. Today, I will be talking to you a little bit about what Varro FX is before we get to the results section. So first, Varro FX is Bayer's new cross-spectrum weed control product, as Rory had already mentioned. The combination of the Group 2 and Group 4 actives gives us excellent control of weeds such as wild oats or the foxtail species, as well as some activity on broadleaves such as kochia, cleavers, wild buckwheat, or volunteer canola. Varro FX is registered on both spring and winter wheat and is very flexible in terms of tank mix partners. This allows growers to choose a tank mix partner based on the weeds present in their field, not by label limitations. One of the most exciting features of Varro FX is the EC formulation. This is the first and only Group 2 EC formulated verminicide available in the marketplace today and comes with huge advantages that we will discuss later on. When looking at who is leading the market with fluroxypyr, you can see that Varro FX is among the top. This allows for an improvement on broadleaf activity over many of our competitors. Varro FX has a lot of value and power in a small package. So now we want to show you some of the results for some of the trials that we've done across Western Canada in the past 3 years. The market development group ran this trial over the past 3 years, and we had several main goals. The first was to understand the evolution from Varro to Varro FX. We really wanted to understand what that fluroxypyr was bringing to the table in terms of broadleaf control, as well as what that EC formulation means in terms of grassy weed control. Our next goal was to get hands-on experience with the product and learn as much as we can about it before we move to launch it in 2024. We were also looking at comparing tank mix partners with Varro FX to see where the strengths and weaknesses are for each product across different weed spectrums in Western Canada. We were also looking to compare Varro FX against key current market offerings. We want to see how we stack up in terms of crop tolerance as well as weed efficacy. Like I mentioned before, we conducted this trial across 8 market development farms in Western Canada over the past 3 years in spring wheat. We set this trial up as a 3-rep randomized complete block design, and our primary measurements were phytotoxicity, or that crop tolerance, as well as weed efficacy. Okay, so if we move into the treatment list next, we can see the first 2 treatments are those that we would not recommend growers to spray, but we really wanted to see the differences between base Varro and Varro FX. So we were really looking at the OD formulation versus the EC formulation, as well as what fluroxypyr is bringing to base Varro for broadleaf control. The rest of the treatments were split into 2 main segments, the first segment being tank mix partners. So we were looking at comparing Varro FX tank mix with Infinity herbicide, 2,4-D herbicide, MCPA herbicide, Buctrel M herbicide, and Thumper herbicide. The last segment was our competitive standard. So we looked at treatments of Simplicity Go Dry herbicide with Octane herbicide, Everest 3.0 herbicide with Octane herbicide, Irbis Extreme herbicide, and 2,4-D herbicide. If we jump into the phytotoxicity results, we can see here that the bars represent the averages across all trials done in Western Canada, and the individual dots represent each individual trial. So you can see that the averages across all treatments in this trial are below 5%. 5% phytotoxicity is considered extremely crop safe. At 5%, you're really not going to be able to see what's going on in a field. You'll be able to see something's going on, but you can't really explain it. So anything below that 5% cutoff, we're considering extremely crop safe. So you can see Varro FX across the board is doing extremely well, especially in comparison to our competitors. If we move into the weed control aspect of this trial next, we want to look at wild oat control first. So this is our 3-year wrap-up of our wild oat control across Western Canada. The first thing I want to draw your attention to are these first two treatments. So when you're controlling these wild oats, it's still the fine carbazone in Varro and Varro FX that's controlling your wild oats. You can see, though, that you're seeing a 3.2% increase in wild oat control, and this is solely coming from your EC formulation. So that EC formulation is allowing for better coverage on your weeds, better uptake, and better control. This is very exciting for Varro FX as we really highlight that EC formulation. Moving on to the rest of the treatments, you can see across the board, Varro FX doing an extremely good job at controlling those wild oats and very much comparable, if not slightly better than our competitors. Next, if we look into the 2023 results of green and yellow foxtail control, these ratings were taken 21 days after application. You can see the same trend as the wild oats between the Varro to Varro FX and that EC formulation really shining. And a very similar trend across the board here. Varro FX doing extremely well at controlling the foxtails, better than that of our competitors. If we move into the broadleaf species next, we really looked at volunteer canola, wild buckwheat, cleavers, and lamb's quarters for these results. We had 35 hits in our trials for the past 3 years. And the first thing I want to point out is the first three treatments here. So as I mentioned earlier, we would not recommend spraying Varro or Varro FX on their own, and this is really showing why. So when you move from Varro to Varro FX, you can see how much value that fluroxypyr is bringing to that broadleaf control. However, when you add any of the tank mix partners that we have listed here, you can see you're getting an even bigger bump in weed control from that base Varro FX treatment. So this is really illustrating the need for that tank mix partner. Looking across the board at the other treatments, you can see that Varro FX tank mix with 2,4-D or MCPA is doing an extremely good job, but not quite as good as Varro FX tank mix with Buctralam, Thumper, or Infinity. If we draw a line at the 90% weed control, you can see that Varro FX tank mix with any of those options listed is at that 90% or better, while some of our competitors are not quite at that line or below that line. Finally, I want to show you the results of our 3-year wrap-up on the kochia control. Kochia has been a hot topic in Western Canada, and rightfully so. And this trial is really illustrating where we see the fit for Varro FX in terms of kochia control in Western Canada. You can see the dots that are kind of lower and closer down to the bottom, really showing that resistance is likely an issue in these treatments. You can see that the fluoxypyr is bringing quite a bit of value over the regular Varro, but still seeing an improvement with tank mix partners such as Infinity. And what I really wanted to point out here is how close these dots are together in terms of controlling that kochia. So what this is telling me is the closer the dots are together, the more consistently that treatment is controlling your kochia. This is also showing how confident we are that a tank mix of Varro FX and Infinity will control kochia, even if you're seeing some resistance in the field like you would with some of these other treatments. They say a picture's worth 1,000 words, and here are four. The first picture on your left-hand side is our untreated check. And this was a trial that we conducted in Carsland, Alberta in 2023, and these pictures were taken 14 days after application. So in that untreated check, you can see it's a heavy population of lamb's quarters as well as kochia, and there's a few other weed species in there. But you can see in that second picture, Varro FX plus MCPA really struggling to control that kochia. And this is something that we expected to see as there's resistance confirmed at that site. The next two pictures of Varro FX tank mix with Buctral M and Thumper showing the added benefit of that step up from your MCPA treatment, but you're still seeing some kochia escapes there. Now, unfortunately, we weren't able to get a picture of the Varro FX plus Infinity tank mix treatment in this trial specifically, but I was able to reach out to a colleague in Northeast Saskatchewan, and he sent me these pictures of Varro FX plus Infinity, also taken 14 days after application, and this one was in 2020. This trial, I also want to point out, had three strips of wheat seeded across from left to right in this picture. So that's the wheat that you're seeing in the right. But this was a heavy population of cleavers, wild mustard, and other wheat species. And you can see that Varro FX plus Infinity was able to clean that right up extremely well. So in terms of key trial takeaways, I've split this into three parts. The first being phytotoxicity. In general, Varro FX is extremely crop safe. It is very comparable with other Group 2 products available in the marketplace, but in general, we are very confident that it is very crop safe. The second part is the wild oat and foxtail comparison. So we were able to see that the formulation alone is improving your weed control. We're also able to see that Varro FX is demonstrating excellent control of those wild oats. And again, very comparable, if not slightly better, than other Group 2 products available in the market today. And then the final point that I wanted to make was that tank mix flexibility. So we were seeing superior broadleaf control with all of our tank mix options. And then we are very excited for the potential of Varro FX and Infinity at controlling kochia across Western Canada.
Thank you, Amanda. That was very informative and interesting results there. We're now going to pass it over to Samantha Clemis, who is going to walk us through some of the ease of use and application that we have noticed or observed with Varro FX.
Thanks, Rory. The formulation of Varro FX is an emulsifiable concentrate, or EC for short, and Varro FX is the only Group 2 EC on the market. As current Group 2 products are typically an oil dispersion or suspension concentrate formulation, and those can be a little more difficult for growers to mix or clean out of their tanks. So this EC formulation is really exciting because it helps improve that customer experience, as no external surfactant is required, so one less step for the grower to worry about. And growers will experience improved handling, mixing, and easier tank and boom cleanout, which also lowers the risk for any herbicide hangup. And this formulation provides enhanced coverage, which results in better uptake and more uniform control in those heavy weed populations. In the 2023 season, market development agronomists across Western Canada executed field-scale Varro FX trials, and we received a lot of positive feedback on its mixing and handling properties. So these are some direct quotes from the market development agronomists and their cooperators that really just further emphasize the benefits of the EC formulation. And this is a video created by our market development team that further demonstrates the mixing ease of Varro FX. Varro FX Herbicide is a new cross-spectrum weed control product and the only Group 2 emulsifiable concentrate product in the market today. The EC formulation not only has great product handling and dispersion qualities, but also has great cleanup characteristics. This video will show the advantages of Bayer's new Varro FX herbicide.
This first video segment shows how Varro FX herbicide disperses quicker and more uniformly into the tank compared to Simplicity Go Dry herbicide, Everest herbicide, and Varro herbicide. Each of the herbicides going into the bottles are at label rate with water volumes equivalent to 10 gallons per acre. This next video shows equal amounts of water being poured over each of the products to demonstrate cleanout ease of Varro FX herbicide in a jug, tank, or can handler.
We will now get into the benefits along with the staging of Varro FX. So we've already discussed the EC formulation and the benefits that provides, including advanced grass control. But to expand on that a little more, this formulation allows Varro FX to control grassy weed species at larger sizes compared to its competitor products. So control of wild oats, green foxtail, and barnyard grass up to that six leaf stage. Another benefit of Varro FX is that the broadleaf tank mix partner can be flexible based on the weeds present in the field. And this is also a really great resistance management tool for broadleaf weeds. And another important benefit is the flexible recrop that Varro FX provides, including in the brown soil zones. This slide shows a really good breakdown of the broadleaf tank mix partner tiers. So starting with your baseline broadleaf tank mix partner options on the left, which includes 2,4-D and MCPA. Tank mixes with either of these options would give two modes of action, but 2,4-D does limit the application window, so something to keep in mind. And this is an option in situations where you're dealing with smaller weeds, for example, kochia in that 2-to-8-leaf stage. The core broadleaf tank mix options include Buckdrill M and Thumper. A tank mix with either of these options would provide three modes of action, but again, the 2,4-D and Thumper would limit the application window. And this is a great tier to choose when dealing with kochia up to 10 centimeters. The last tier is a premium tier, which includes Infinity. This tank mix would give four modes of action and provides the largest window of application. It's also the best option for those large and tough to control weeds. So for example, kochia up to 15 centimeters. So as I mentioned in the previous slide, the broadleaf tank mix partner can be flexible based on the weeds present in the field. And when we think about managing and preventing resistance, having these options with multiple modes of action is really important. One of the key observations in our market development trials this past 2023 season was the rapid activity of Varro FX. So these are some great before and after photos taken by our market development team that demonstrate some of the rapid activity that was observed. So starting in the top left is a picture of volunteer canola on the day of application. Varro FX and Buckjewel M was applied. And then the photo below is 7 days after application. On the top right is a stinkweed on the day of application. Varro FX and Infinity was applied. And then the photo below is 12 days after application. Next, I wanted to talk about staging because with any group two, this is really important. The crop staging for Varro FX is the exact same as the Varro OD formulation. So if you're already familiar with staging for Varro, then that's great and you'll be good to go. But for those that are not, we will go through it. So the staging for spring wheat is between 1 to 6 leaves on the main stem plus 3 tillers. But prior to jointing, which is indicated by the presence of the first node. And I've got a picture here that points out what that first node looks like. And for some background information, nodes are bumps that appear on the main stem above the crown. And the appearance of the first node marks that transition from vegetative to reproductive growth. And you can feel along the main stem with your thumb and index finger for this node. But another easy way to see if there are nodes or not is to open the main stem with a razor to see if there's anything developing. And then for winter wheat, you want to apply in either fall or spring when the majority of the plants have one leaf to full tillering, but again, prior to jointing. And an important watch out is that under drought conditions for spring wheat, do not spray Varro FX if the time between seeding and spraying exceeds 35 days. And this is because drought really quickens that crop development, causing a faster transition between the vegetative and reproductive phase. And we don't want to spray the plant if it has entered into that reproductive phase. So this is an important note to keep in mind. And I'll wrap up my section with a few key reminders. The first is that Varro FX should never go down alone. Although it does have broadleaf weeds on label, it's considered a broadleaf booster and should always have a broadleaf tank mix partner alongside it for control across many weed spectrums. And then my second reminder, as we discussed in the previous slide, proper crop staging is very important. And it's important for all Group 2 products. They should be applied early for both optimal performance and efficacy, but also for crop tolerance. And lastly, keeping in mind that tank mixes that include 2,4-D do narrow the window of application as they cannot be applied until the fourth leaf stage. And similar to key competitor products, a small increase in crop phytotoxicity may be observed when mixing with 2,4-D, but overall, Varro FX crop tolerance is superior to key competitor products when mixed with 2,4-D. And I'll end my section by showing this Varro FX testimonial video.
My name is Brett Tiedart. I work for Cargill, and I'm a market development agronomist out of Elba, Manitoba.
Brian Van Malkenberg, in between Deloraine and Boisvane, along the Turtle Mountains.
My name is Martin Nescapo. I farm at Goodlands, Manitoba.
The biggest thing that stood out to me was the formulation. Handling it through the chem handler, there was no visible residue left in the chem handler that you're struggling to clean out, so it's that peace of mind that you're not having that carryover for the next crop coming down the sprayer's path.
Really, being a group two, we really like it, and like for our rotations and the way it mixes, it's just absolutely, it's a game changer.
Ease of application compared to the old barrel, much less sticky, easier to handle. That was the best part.
I think something simple like Buck Troll M will go a long ways with us. We do have a lot more buckwheat around here, but being able to tank mix it with Fluroxypure, I feel like that'll give us a pretty strong tank mix for kind of the general weeds that we have in the region. We go from a very light sandy soil to a very heavy clay in a very short time span or area. So that that flexibility is going to be great and easier to manage in our chem shed for chemistries.
Likely Bucktrill and Infinity.
Bucktrill, yeah.
Definitely saw some promising things on the grassies. This hot, dry spring we had, definitely seen some challenges, especially with some Group 1 formulations on resistance. I hope it's not more resistance developing and it was just the conditions, but that another tool in the tool shed for the grass resistance and chemical rotations is great. Another key driver weed for us that it has to be on label for us to use a chemistry is that kochia. It really opens up the opportunity to use some chemistries that don't have kochia on label or are a little bit weaker on kochia, but we know that Fluroxypure in there is going to do a good job for what we need.
I would like to thank all the retails, all the cooperators that participated in our RA program this past season to help us bring Varro FX and launch it into the market. I now want to take some time to go over a few key takeaways from today's presentation. So Varro FX, it's a new formulation, but it's not just a new formulation, it's new solutions and all that definition of that word solution. It's going to be providing enhanced solution to your grass weed control because it's enhancing that EC formulation to improve that grass weed control. And those combination of active ingredients will also be bringing along and improving your broadleaf control. Its flexibility is providing solutions to ease of handling. Its flexibility to customize with Varro FX what tank mix you throw in there to really target the problem weeds in your field for your needs. Varro FX has a very favorable, flexible recropping profile that you can recrop to a lot of sensitive crops like lentils, like peas, like chickpeas, and canola. As we saw in some of the videos, Varro FX really demonstrates ease of use. It goes into solution easy, and it comes out of the sprayer booms chem handler very easy, not getting stuck up, not getting hung up anywhere, really allowing that to be an easier process on you and a less stressful process as well. Also, it provides that flexibility and ease of how do you want to handle and move this product around. It provides actually true bulk stability. If you want jugs, yes, you can have them and you can continue to smash jugs and not worry about them getting tied up in your chem handler. But Varro FX also provides true bulk stability that we have 320 acre options for bulk offerings. So it's not just a new formulation, it's also new solutions for you and your farm. Thank you very much for your time today. On this last side, you will see that we have included a QR code for CCA and CCSC credits. Thank you very much for your time today.